very much, Loretta, following Colin's eloquence, and with the memory of the, not just the President's words, but the President's warning about that handkerchief in our pocket, I will be brief in my introduction. The President, as Colin has, for many of us, has not just been a supporter of the Ireland Funds, but she's been a leader and an inspirer in so many things that she has done. And I remember, Loretta remembered one occasion she said, stay with us. I remember New York dinner a few years ago, when the Northern Ireland, the headline-grabbing situations in Northern Ireland had diminished. And she said, stay with us, because she knew that there was unfinished business. But she also, I think, suspected there was unfinished business in the rest of the, in the rest of the country. And there was sort of a lot still to do. And I had the privilege of being in Washington when Antisha Genda-Kenny addressed the American Ireland Fund Board. And at the end of it, Loretta stood up and said, okay, Taoiseach, what do you want us to do? We are here to help. I tell you, boy, have the American, the Ireland Funds in general, but the American Ireland Funds been here to help over the last number of months. And I've seen that through the extraordinary generosity and the extraordinary momentum that there is behind it. And it's not just in the attitude. As Kieran McLaughlin says, Americans are great. They don't do retribution. They don't do retribution. They do accountability, but they don't do retribution. So it was, how do we move forward? How do we break out of the situation that we're in? But they didn't leave it in talk. The Promising Ireland campaign, which is a phenomenal achievement, but also is going to do amazing good. And sort of the Ireland Fund are on kind of fire in the last couple of days with inspiring leadership. And on the talk of inspiring leadership, I would also like to echo what Kieran said at the outset and salute the extraordinary leadership of the chairman, co-chairman of the Ireland Fund of Great Britain, Basil Geoghegan, who actually climbed Mount Everest, and raised funds. To raise funds for the phenomenal Forgotten Irish campaign. We're delighted here to have a couple of very special guests in addition to the President and Senator Martin McAleese. Minister Francis Fitzgerald, we're delighted to be here. The government has decided that there needs to be a specific focus and a specific new department for children. And I think that's something that particularly applauds and resonates with the fund, because it's amazing. I got into the Ireland Funds originally because of Northern Ireland, and still stay because of Northern Ireland, as the President has said, is unfinished business. But one of the things that I've seen in the projects that you have supported and signed off grants for today, were the projects that more and more, as we go around and I see the projects that we're working with in Dublin, a common theme comes through. The children in very difficult circumstances, given ability and given encouragement, can do extraordinary things. And that is a huge thing that we're behind. And so we salute. I remember the amazing images in Dublin, amazing images yesterday. And so when I heard the story of the girl Ailish, this girl from Moy Ross, whose single mother brought her up, and rather than sending her 2 minutes up the road, send her an hour away to go to a school where she would have a chance. And she ended up in the University of Limerick, and she was just fantastic yesterday. And that is what the Ireland Fund is doing for children who have incredible ability, is giving them the ability to do that. And so we are particularly thrilled and pleased that the Minister for Children should come down and be with us tonight to sort of to signify that work. And we wish you all the best. I would like to take also on your behalf, and briefly, and I won't dwell long, to thank Ambassador Julian King and his wife Lana. Julian is not just a friend of Ireland, but he's a friend of a lot of us here in the room. And I think he'll look back, history will look back and say, one of the greatest ambassadors that we have had, and he presided over that incredible event. And it was so good in the session this morning that we didn't see one video, but it was so good we watched it twice. But I think we could have kept watching it because of the amazing atmosphere. And Kieran, in his introduction, as the President was saying to me earlier, this small kind of rump group of people who protested. And I, watching those images on TV, reminded me of going up to Croke Park on an historic day a few years ago when God Save the Queen was first played, and seeing little groups of protesters and their sullen and negative attitude contrasted with the enthusiasm of the thousands and thousands of Irish and English supporters who were passing by, streaming by to that historic occasion. And the feeling that went through my mind was that they were so much yesterday's men and yesterday's people. And their placards proclaimed that their day would come. But actually what I felt that day was that our day was coming. And as the President has said, we're not right there. But our day was coming in an Ireland more comfortable than ever in its relationship with its nearest neighbour. Our day was coming in an Ireland with a deeper understanding of our northern unionist neighbours than we ever had before. And it just showed how out of touch the dissident Republicans and now the dissident unionists are with the sort of the aspirations of the Ireland of today and their dreams for tomorrow. So we celebrate and thank again Ambassador King and all the people who made that special event possible. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Limerick and Clare, for the last couple of days. Thank you to Michael Houlihan, our board member, who has driven the fact that this is down here. Thank all the people from the various institutions, educational and other institutions, who have made these days special. Thanks especially to JP and Noreen for an amazing evening on Wednesday night. For showing sort of leadership in philanthropy at home. So we go away, I'll tell you certainly the Irish crowd here, we go away charged and challenged. The American Ireland Fund, you're doing amazing stuff. I'm so proud of the Young Leaders campaign that you have brought and now the Young Leaders here in Ireland. So I think all together we can do, you know, extraordinary things and look forward to building on the success of this weekend. And my great pleasure, we've had a wonderful day in Limerick, a couple of days in Limerick yesterday. We saw the challenge, we saw the ingenuity, we saw the genius, we saw the spark, we saw the creativity, we saw the amazing spirit that is in this amazing city. It's great to come here when you're not actually playing rugby against them, so you don't go back actually with studs down your back and cuts in your head. But it's really special, and the diversity of what is going on in this city is extraordinary. Micheál showed us something last night. I first saw Micheál Asuwon in a Sense of Ireland concert in Hammersmith in London a number of years ago. And I think it was a couple of years before Riverdance. And I was just amazed at this Irish artist who was playing Irish music with piano and orchestra and jazz and all the other stuff. And I came away absolutely, you know, blown away by it, in the same spirit that a couple of years later people would be sort of blown away by Riverdance. And last night, in the University of Limerick, he showed us something special of what's going on there. And the dance of anybody who saw it, imagine trying to follow Riverdance. But what you and the people there was last night was exciting and special. So we're all delighted. Thank you everybody for being with us tonight and look forward to being entertained by the unique Micheál Asuwon.